Chapter 14. In the second year of Jehoash, son of Jehoahaz, king of Israel, began Amaziah, the son of Joash, king of Judah, to reign. He was 25 years old when he began to reign, and he reigned 29 years in Jerusalem. And his mother's name was Jehoadin of Jerusalem. He did that which was right in the eyes of the Lord, yet not like David his father. He did according to all that Joash his father had done. However, the high places were not taken away. The people still sacrificed and burnt incense in the high places. It happened, as soon as the kingdom was established in his hand, that he killed his servants who had slain the king his father. But the children of the murderers he didn't put to death, according to that which is written in the book of the law of Moses, as the Lord commanded, saying, "The fathers shall not be put to death for the children, nor the children be put to death for the fathers, but every man shall die for his own sin." He killed of Edom in the Valley of Saul 10,000, and took Selah by war, and called the name of it Jokthiel to this day. Then Amaziah sent messengers to Jehoash, the son of Jehoahaz, son of Jehu, king of Israel, saying, "Come, let's look one another in the face." Jehoash, the king of Israel, sent to Amaziah, king of Judah, saying, "The thistle that was in Lebanon sent to the cedar that was in Lebanon, saying, 'Give your daughter to my son as a wife.' And there passed by a wild animal that was in Lebanon, and trod down the thistle. You have indeed struck Edom, and your heart has lifted you up. Glory in your victory, but abide at home. For why should you meddle to your hurt that you should fall, even you and Judah with you?" But Amaziah would not listen. So Jehoash, king of Israel, went up. He and Amaziah, king of Judah, looked one another in the face at Beth Shemesh, which belongs to Judah. Judah was put to the worse before Israel, and they fled every man to his tent. Jehoash, king of Israel, took Amaziah, king of Judah, the son of Joash, the son of Ahaziah, at Beth Shemesh, and came to Jerusalem, and broke down the wall of Jerusalem from the gate of Ephraim to the corner gate, 400 cubits. He took all the gold and silver, and all the vessels that were found in the house of the Lord, and in the treasures of the king's house, the hostages also, and returned to Samaria. Now the rest of the acts of Jehoash which he did, and his might, and how he fought with Amaziah king of Judah, aren't they written in the books of the chronicles of the kings of Israel? Jehoash slept with his fathers, and was buried in Samaria with the kings of Israel, and Jeroboam his son reigned in his place. Amaziah the son of Joash, king of Judah, lived after the death of Jehoash son of Jehoahaz, king of Israel, 15 years. Now the rest of the acts of Amaziah, aren't they written in the book of the chronicles of the kings of Judah? They made a conspiracy against him in Jerusalem, and he fled to Lachish. But they sent after him to Lachish and killed him there. They brought him on horses, and he was buried in Jerusalem with his fathers in the city of David. All the people of Judah took Azariah, who was 16 years old, and made him king in the place of his father Amaziah. He built Eleth, and restored it to Judah. After that the king slept with his fathers. In the 15th year of Amaziah the son of Joash, king of Judah, Jeroboam the son of Jehoash, king of Israel, began to reign in Samaria, and he reigned 41 years. He did that which was evil in the sight of the Lord. He didn't depart from all the sins of Jeroboam the son of Nebat, with which he made Israel to sin. He restored the border of Israel from the entrance of Hamath to the sea of the Arabah, according to the word of the Lord, the God of Israel, which he spoke by his servant Jonah the son of Amittai the prophet, who was of Gath-hepher. For the Lord saw the affliction of Israel, that it was very bitter, for there was none shut up, nor left at large, neither was there any helper for Israel. The Lord didn't say that he would blot out the name of Israel from under the sky, but he saved them by the hand of Jeroboam, the son of Jehoash. Now the rest of the acts of Jeroboam, and all that he did, and his might, how he warred and how he recovered Damascus and Hamath, which had belonged to Judah for Israel, aren't they written in the book of the chronicles of the kings of Israel? Jeroboam slept with his fathers, even with the kings of Israel, and Zechariah his son reigned in his place.